so that's squeaky bell.
In 200 yards at the roundabout, continue straight.
Right, it's that time of year again. Need to get some maintenance done to the Citroen AMI. The belt's been squealing, the drive belt's been squealing for at least a year. I've tightened it up as much as I can, run out of adjustment now, so I think the belt needs changed. So last year I bought another belt from Citroen. It's been lying about all year, so get that fitted shortly. To get that belt removed. It's just two big bolts that go through, need to slacken off, and hopefully there's enough stretch in the belt to get it over the pulleys when it's fully unadjusted. Right then, if you can see it, there's a T50 Torx there and a T50 Torx there that need to be slackened off. Slackened, and that's as far as it will go down there. So is there enough to slide the belt off? Or will I need to take the bolt? Oh, it's actually hitting up here on the... So you can see this runs out of travel against that mount. So I might have to pull the bolt out and tilt the motor. Front bolt out. So I might be able to get the belt off by leaving it like that, but whether the new one will go in that way is a different matter. Yeah, that looks way tight. Yeah, I think we'll take the pulleys off. Right, get this nut off. 24mm. And see if we can get this in. Slide it off. That's probably slightly splined onto the motor. Yeah. Yeah, just splines onto the self-cutting splines into the pulley. A little bit of grunting. So, what's the... there we are. Just need to persuade the last little bit. One tooth out there. Hang on. Take this back off again. Famous last words. Take this back off again. that's it going. That's it. That's that. That's on. A bit of a struggle. Tricky. Got a wobbly. So close to going in. There we are. We're in there. Let's try that. Come on, get on. That's it on. Right, just get the bolts back in again. Right. It was very tight getting past the lip of the pulley. But it's going in now. The front one in. I'm showing about 47 point. Where are we? 47.3. I'm going to check the dimension. So you're measuring the shortest point of the between the two interfaces of the pulleys. You can get a lever in the back here and pull backwards against the bracket at the back and the casing of the motor, and you can pull that back and then tighten the two bolts to get the tension on the belt and correct tension. That gap across there between the inside of that pulley and the inside of that pulley should be about 48 and a half. I think I've got about 48.35 or something when I tried that. 48 and a half I've got. I think that's tight enough. We'll see how it goes. Certainly doesn't want to tighten any more than that at the moment. See if it stretches or rides in. That should do for the moment. Hindsight, I think it might be possible to get this to get enough clearance for the belt fitting by taking off the two bolts out of the top mounts, taking off the two bolts that bolt that bracket to the top of the differential, and I think then there'll be enough room to slide the motor further down, because at the moment the motor hits against there. I think there'll be enough room then to tilt the motor over and get the clearance to get the belt on without taking pulleys off. Just my theory, but I think that's possible. Yeah, I think that's possibly the way that might work.